everyone. My name is Chrissy Hayes and I'm the Child Protection Subsector Coordinator in Cox's Bazar, Bangladesh. And I'm here with my colleague, Jacob Sarkar, leading the Save the Children Child Protection Program in Cox's Bazar. Cox's Bazar hosts the largest refugee camp in the world, with over 850,000 refugees, of which half are children. The child protection subsector falls under the protection sector generally and forms part of a wider intersectoral coordination body working closely to support refugees in what are already overcrowded and over-congested camps conducive to the spread of disease. In an effort to contain the spread of COVID-19, on the 8th of April, the government of Bangladesh restricted the humanitarian footprint in the camp to 20%, of which the priority was given to the health sector. Child protection partners were only permitted a maximum of 137 caseworkers in the camp on any given day. This required a rapid and dramatic reliance on volunteers and community level actors for all child protection activities, and importantly, required a much stronger collaboration between the health sector and the child protection actors to ensure protection of children in this context. It was quickly recognised that COVID-19 was likely to lead to the temporary or perhaps permanent separation of children and caregivers in the event that either children or caregivers were admitted to facilities or quarantined. With limited presence and reduced access, the child protection subsector collaborated closely with the health sector to identify the range of scenarios and develop clear guidance for both sectors to ensure children were supported and received a continuity of care. This is just a brief background to the development of the document and the context, which my colleague Jacob will explain in more detail.
Hello. The guidance document includes a section on terms and their definition to promote a shared language between the two sectors. This was critical as teams were learning new terminology around COVID and needed to ensure that CP and health actors had a shared understanding. Exploration of guiding principle as it relates to COVID-19 and alternative care. We explored various risks that children and their families may face in health facilities. This includes risks such as formerly healthy children or adult accompany their family member into the ITC and contact COVID. Caregivers are admitted and their children are left without adequate childcare. Third is children are abandoned. And fourth, but not least, children, especially adolescents, run away from the centers and so on. Learning on established referral pathways, the guidance take into account specific COVID considerations for health actors conducting safe referrals, discharge protocols, and links to contextualized and global resources. You will note that I did not mention the scenario planning component. I'll do now go into this a bit further. The scenario planning is the meat of the document. It aims to provide practical guidance to health and CP actors on the following 7 scenarios in quarantine centers. Quarantine centers are where contacts are kept and monitored for symptoms. Isolation centers, where there are mild to moderate cases, and ITC, where there are moderate to severe cases, for example, where patients need oxygen. Across each of these spaces, the document explores what to do when both the child and caregiver are symptomatic. When the child is asymptomatic and the caregiver is symptomatic. When the reverse happens and the child is symptomatic and the caregiver is asymptomatic. And then what to do if an unaccompanied child is at one of the centers? A child has to be admitted without a caregiver. And what to do if the separation is just temporary while waiting for test results. In addition to this, in each health facility, several staff were identified as child carers and trained to talk through care options and caregivers, provide care to unaccompanied and separated children in health facilities, run psychosocial activities, and utilize child-friendly language to orient children to the facility.
Thankfully, the number of cases in Cox's Bazar has not spiked in the way that we feared. This document serves as a critical piece of preparedness for future waves and/or pandemics. We now have child carers in health facilities trained and ready to respond. This document provided a platform for increased coordination between the two sectors, and we are happy to report that the quarantine approach has worked with child protection volunteers supporting children and caregivers in quarantine centres. Thank you for your time, and we look forward to speaking with you further at the panel.